Welcome to the Django project, DJ Blogger. This tutorial is part of a YouTube Django project playlist, which you can access in the video description. You can watch the whole course from the very beginning. If you enjoy this course and would like all the updated tutorials and associated code samples and more, you can check out this course and other courses this project features at Udemy. The link to the course is in the video description. In the previous section of this course, we created a new GitHub repository on github.com. So what we're going to do first is we're going to create a new GitHub branch. So you need to navigate your way over to github.com, go over to your repository, and we'll go ahead and now create a new GitHub branch. So we have our main branch. This main branch is our default. So I click here on main. You can see it's the default branch. That means that this is the branch that anyone is going to see if they were to navigate to our repository. Now, of course, we have set up this repository. You can see up here the padlock at the top here. We've set it to private, so no one can actually see this repository anyway. But if it was public, that would be the default branch. Now, we can use this main branch as a way of saying, okay, this is the current and latest code, working code for our application. Now, let's imagine we have four groups of developers here now who are going to develop this application. What we can now do, each of those four groups or four developers can go ahead and download this version of our code, our currently up-to-date code, which is tested, for example, and they can go ahead and develop a certain component maybe of this application. So that might then all be then uploaded or merged into a different branch before it then gets converted into main. So by doing that, by creating different branches, it means that others can work on different maybe versions of our application, or they can work on different parts of the application without necessarily having to worry about overriding or making any breaking changes to the actual version of our code, which we know is working and is perfect, our main branch. So let's go ahead and create a new branch here. So this is going to be for development. The idea here is that we're going to develop another feature of our application when we're ready. When we're ready and we've tested it, we're then going to merge it with our main branch, which we know is the main core branch for our application. So go into your branches here. So click on this drop down, view branches, and then add a new branch. Let's do it. So let's call this branch dev for development. This is going to be our development branch, version 1.0.1. And then you can see the branch source. So we're going to select where we want to make this branch from. So we're going to copy all the code from main and make our new branch. So let's create a new branch. And there we go. So if I go back into my code here, you can now see I have two branches. So now go back into your GitHub desktop, click on fetch origin. Okay. And now what we can do is then potentially select the development branch from the list. We should have the main and the development. So let's select development. And there we go. So we're now working in this development branch. So if we were to make any changes here, so let's, for example, go into our settings file. Let's go to, for example, local. And let's just type in something like import math. For example, let's go back. Into our GitHub desktop, you can see we've made changes and it's recording those changes. So what we can do now is we can go ahead and make a new commit. So let's commit this to the dev branch. That's important. Push it to the origin. And now what we have is a new version with some new code. So you can see that we have created a push less than a minute ago. What we can do now is in this new branch here, this is the, sorry, if we go to our development, what we can do is we can eventually merge this code into our main branch. So that's going to be really useful. So the idea here is that we're going to develop some aspects of our code, of our application, and then merge it into our main, which is, remember, I'm just repeating myself now, I realize that. That's our main core branch. Right, so we'll learn and we'll do that later on, but let's get on with the rest of this section of the course.